Adding visual elements to your Notion page can make your pages pop and make it more personalized. With Notion, you can add both simple images and full databases with images called Gallery View. In this video, we wanted to show you all about Gallery View as well as some of our top tips and tricks. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first thing we wanted to cover are all the ways you can create gallery views in Notion. So the first easiest way is to type /gallery, and then you can simply click gallery view database and then plus new gallery to create a new gallery view database. And this is an inline database, so you can basically add things above or below it, or even put it inside columns and all sorts of things. So it's a very flexible way to add a gallery view. The other option is to turn the whole page into a database. To do that, you would need to go to the bottom of the page, three dots here, and then click gallery, and it's going to transform this whole page into a gallery view database. You can click plus new gallery and you have a gallery view here. Another way you can add gallery view is from an existing database. So if you have an existing database here, we can go to the three dots and then go to layout and then change the view into gallery. So this is a great way if you already have an existing data set that you want to show in gallery view. Next, let's talk about some use cases for gallery view in case you're wondering when is the best time to use a gallery view database. Some gallery view use cases might include journal covers, project databases, photo galleries, and in situations where you want to highlight the cover photo of the page before opening it. However, there are no rules for gallery view, so feel free to experiment. We've also used it without the cover image to showcase quotes in this example. The next thing we wanted to talk about is how to change your card preview. So as you can see here, we have this inside of the card showing on the outside like this at the moment. And if you want to edit that, you can simply go to the three dots here and then go to layout and then go to card preview. So right now it sets the page content. If we click here, you can either choose none, page cover, or page content. So if we choose page cover, which is the way that we normally use gallery view databases, then you can actually click one open, add a cover photo like this, change cover, for example. And we like to go to Unsplash, which has a huge stock image library. So if we were looking for some productivity images, we can go ahead and put a picture here like this, and it's going to show up in our gallery view. However, the other option is also pretty useful if you wanted to show card preview to be page content, especially if you want to see a preview of what's inside already. So this can be also a really good idea. But if you do use the page content and you add a cover photo here, so if we put an image like this and then we add a photo through Unsplash, for example, like this, it's actually going to show the first image as the cover image like this. The other way we like to use gallery view is by going to our layout and changing it to none. So sometimes this can be a really good way to display your information in these kinds of card blocks. So we've done things like showing quotes or showing, for example, your different platforms that if you're making a content planner, for example. So this is another really cool way to use gallery view databases. Another thing in terms of displaying images in your gallery view is that you can add a property for files and media. And when you do this, you actually unlock another option by going to your three dots here, layout, and then if you go to card preview, you now have the option to display your files and media. So if we click this one, if you upload a file here, then it's going to show that image as its cover photo. So let's say that we uploaded this image here, then it's going to now show this as the cover photo of our gallery view. Our next tip that we have for gallery view databases is actually that you can hide the title. So for a long time, we didn't realize that this was possible. So we thought that it would be nice to mention that you can actually hide the titles of your gallery view databases so you only see images. So if we go to the three dots here and then we go to properties, you can actually go here and hide the name. And that makes this really nice view where it's only the images here, and it provides a really clean look. And for example, if you wanted to add the text on the image, that's also possible in this format. The next tip we wanted to show is that you can resize your gallery view images here. So right now, if we go to our three dots here and then we go to layout, you can see card size is set to medium. If you wanted to show it smaller, you can choose small or you can choose large depending on your needs. So this is also nice that you have three options in terms of how to display your gallery. the next neat trick that we have for you is that you can actually change the way that your images are displayed. So if we go to this three dots here and then go to layout and we go to fit image, if you turn this one on, it actually shows the exact image that you are using for the cover photo. So this can be really useful if you're into photography and have different image sizes that don't necessarily fit into the gallery view cover photo image. So we would recommend turning this on for different kinds of photos, depending on if you need to see everything. You can also reposition the images if we click here and we drag it around. So if it's not on the fit mode, you can actually just drag this so that it's exactly at the position that you want. So if we show our name again here, then you might notice that this one has this page icon, and this is because we have something written inside already. And if you feel bothered by the fact that all of these have to have an icon, then you can actually turn that off by going to the three dots here and then go to layout and then toggle off show page icon. This is one of Notion's newer features, and we really like this because you don't always want an icon. So we would highly recommend checking this and turning it off if you don't need it. So next, let's go over some useful properties to show in your gallery view databases. So if we click one open, some of our favorite properties are, of course, tags, because sometimes you want to tag it by different categories. So we might have tags here. We might also want to add another property by clicking plus add property, a checkbox. So that's another one of our favorites. And this can be anything from done or whether or not you want to archive it. So this is another favorite property of ours when it comes to gallery view. And if we go ahead and click plus add a property again, you can see all of the options here. So you can try adding all of these depending on your needs. And let's say we wanted to add a text property here and we had lots of text. And if we click out, now what we can do is display these properties by going to the three dots here, properties, and then you can showcase every single property you currently have. And what's interesting is if you have a lot of text here, then you might want to add something called wrap. So you can see here that the text cuts off here. So if we go to the three dots here and then we go to layout, you can turn on wrap all properties. And this way you can see everything that gets shown here. So the next thing we wanted to show is that you can actually group your gallery view as well. And this can make it look very interesting. So if we go to the three dots here and then go to group, you can group it, for example, by your tags. So this is in the productivity tag, and this one doesn't have any tags. And what's neat is that you can actually drag them into different categories. So this makes it very intuitive if you want to showcase your images and gallery view cards inside of these groupings. The next thing we wanted to show is quickly that you can search through, you can sort, and you can filter through your gallery view, just like any other database view. If you want to filter, you have all the options depending on your property. So if you wanted to see whether or not it's done or not, you could turn this one on. You can also sort it by the created time, ascending or descending, and you can also search for something. So let's say we're looking for page two. It's immediately going to search page two. So the next tip we have is slightly more advanced, and that is that gallery view is one of the best database views to add buttons to. So if we open up one of our entries and we click plus add a property, we can add a database button and we can configure what the button does when it's clicked. So let's say that this is going to change the status of done into a checked box. So let's say that instead of our done checkbox, we're just going to create a button that's going to check it off for us. We can add an action, which is that it edits the page inside of this page, and we can choose what property it's going to edit. So let's say that the done is going to be checked when it's clicked. Then we can save it like this. So for example, if we click out, instead of this checkbox like this, it might look nicer if we click the three dots here, properties, and we showcase the done button and hide the done checkbox. So now if we click done, we can open it up and see that it's checked off. So if you're using the checkbox as a sort of method to categorize your information And you don't want to necessarily show the checkbox. You can do a lot with these database buttons. You can even add pages to a separate database when you click on it. So be sure to check out our video all about buttons that we also have that can give you more insight and more details on this, but we highly recommend buttons in Gallery View. Finally, another thing we wanted to show you regarding Gallery View databases is that you can limit the number of Gallery View entries that are shown. So this can take a lot of your page space. So if you wanted to show a little bit less of them, you can go to your three dots here, and then you can go to load limit. And if you wanted to change it to 10 pages, it's only going to maximum show 10, and then the rest you'd have to click to show more, which can be a nice way to save some page space. So now you might be wondering, what if you just want to add a simple image? You can type /image and simply upload something that's not in a Gallery View database, and you can embed link, you can use Unsplash, you can also use Jiffy. So all of these are really useful options. If we, for example, added some kind of productivity image, then we can add something like this. And you have a lot of options in terms of how it's displayed. It can be on the left, the right, or the center. And you can also add captions, and you can do all of these actions on the image as well. So we would highly recommend using a simple image over a Gallery View if you simply just want to display an image inside of your text. However, if you want to organize your images in any kind of way, or they actually act more like cover photos for your database pages, we would recommend Gallery View. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope this was helpful. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.